You are listening to the American Urbex podcast. American Urbex advocates responsible urban exploration in the name of education, preservation, and adventure. You can find maps, detailed research, and photos from our explorations at AmericanUrbex.com. My name is Ken Fager, and you are listening to episode 18 of the American Urbex podcast. This week, we're going to take a break from the regular format to discuss a couple of issues that concern the future of the website. The first issue I want to address is the server woes that I've been experiencing. 2 years ago, when I set up American Urbex, it was nothing but a proof of concept for a grad course that I was taking. I did very well on that project, and I never anticipated that American Urbex would actually grow as I grew as a photographer, or lead me to the places that I've been, or get me in contact with just wonderful people who have made this project so much fun, and it's something that I want to keep on going. 2 years ago, when I decided to set up the website, because I thought it was just going to be a short-term thing, I went with a bargain bin host called UltraSurge. Now, I had been with UltraSurge for years on my personal website, and because it doesn't get a whole lot of traffic, the bargain basement service was exactly as you'd expect. Recently, though, whenever I tried to run backup scripts, my internet service provider would get blacklisted, and the firewall would prevent me from doing any sort of significant maintenance or updates, and you can bet that it's pretty hard to administer a website if you cannot access it. So in order to get to the website, I've had to either go through the 3G network on my phone or go sit at and use the Wi-Fi at my local McDonald's. So that's not something I enjoy. McDonald's food does not suit my palate very well. So, in the process of getting my data and getting those databases, UltraSurge has been trying to block my every attempt. I've tried backing up to Dropbox. That hasn't worked. I downloaded the entire database. The important thing is I got the files. I should have been more diligent 2 years ago with setting up a more rigorous backup process. The themes were backed up. The databases were backed up. A lot of the images were not, and that was the bulk of what I needed today. I got them. Don't worry about it. I made a backup to Dropbox and my flash drive almost immediately. The data's there. As I'm sitting here and talking to you, though, the website is currently down. When I ran that backup, that entire backup of the database, for some reason, the WordPress install that I had been using completely wiped out. So that's the final straw. I cannot take it anymore. And so this last week, I purchased a new hosting plan for the next 3 years. Hopefully, they'll be much better providing service. And so even though things didn't go as expected today and we're experiencing a little bit of downtime, American Urbex will be back, and I'll take this as a lesson learned and be more rigorous with those backups. You know, I've poured so much time and energy into this project. It's really starting. I need to take more assurances that it'll actually be there in the future. So, and I'm guessing you like the site too, which is why you're listening to this podcast. So that's that. We'll move on. Southern Slide, the project that I've been trying to raise funds for and actually have met the fundraising goal for on Indiegogo.com/Southern Slide. We're at $505. The goal was $500. We reached that a little while ago. I got another donation yesterday in the form of a Quaker Oats canister, which I have right here. And this is from my family, my extended family, and I just want to take a moment and thank them for their support. I really had no idea how deep the rabbit hole goes, and I appreciate that they're paying attention, I guess, to what I'm doing, even though it is kind of weird in their eyes. But yeah, so thank you very much. I haven't opened this yet, but I'll save that for when the fundraising effort is completely done on May 5th on Indiegogo.com/Southern Slide. As far as that project goes, I'm starting to look at locations in the South, starting to put together a database of where might be the most beneficial for me to go and photograph and document and research. I basically want to make sure that this money that I raise is well spent. And if you're looking to join me on this trip at certain locations, by all means, get into contact with me at AmericanUrbex@gmail.com. We can work something out, maybe set something up. The important dates are going to be working with my grad school schedule. And the process for that is that I'm in the middle of my grad research right now. I'm collecting data, getting things together for my study, which is on iOS deployment methods in Wisconsin K-12 schools, which is going swimmingly at the moment, but I'm going to be wrapping up the data collection phase fairly soon for that. I have to parse the data out, and then I have to submit my research, and I will be very busy with that, finishing my master's degree and getting that taken care of. That's my top priority, but somewhere in there I'd like to squeeze in some exploration. So, yeah, I'm going to make this happen one way or the other. I'm going to make it successful. So again, thank you to all my funders who are making this a possibility during this stressful time. I'll need a pleasant distraction. Okay, so future episodes of the American Urbex podcast. Looking back in the stats for the podcast, the most popular podcast kind of surprised me. It's not one of those ones where I go over the history of the location, but rather it's an interview I conducted with one of my friends and another person who has become my friend since then. So I urge you to go back and listen to episode 7 of the American Urbex podcast, which takes place in United Methodist Church in Gary, Indiana, which is a very popular Urbex spot in that city. One of the things that I would like to do is do more of those one-on-one interviews with Urbex photographers, and if you are interested in that, by all means, again, contact me at AmericanUrbex@gmail.com. Drop me a line. I'll see if I can work something out. I ask that when you contact me, include a link to some of your work that you've published so I can kind of get an idea of, you know, who you are and what you're into, and we can definitely work from that point. I'd like to do more interviews with people who have perspectives other than my own on Urbex and what it is that we do in this hobby. So, yeah, give me a shout out and we'll take it from there. Before I wrap things up here, there is one more item I'd like to address. You guys are blowing my mind on the American Urbex Flickr group. There's some great photos being uploaded. In particular, I'm looking at the Kings Park Psychiatric Center photos by Photo Wrapper. These black and whites of these husks of these buildings are blowing my mind. They're absolutely gorgeous. So I highly recommend checking those out. Give it a shot. We're on Flickr. Just search for American Urbex and you'll see the group there. So hey, if you got a couple Urbex photos, couldn't hurt to add those too. All right. I know it's been a weird episode. I promise we'll get back to our regularly scheduled program next time. Thank you for listening to the American Urbex podcast. Be sure to explore AmericanUrbex.com to keep tabs on our latest Urbex outings. Twitter users can get real-time updates by following at American Urbex. If you're a Facebook user, we've got you covered at facebook.com/AmericanUrbex. If you have a comment or question for American Urbex, please send them to AmericanUrbex@gmail.com.